Everyone, and welcome back to my channel. So today I'm going to be showing you guys my jewellery collection. This video has been asked for so many times over the years and I've always kind of disregarded it because I thought that it would be a little bit boring, just me showing you my jewellery, but I just can't ignore the requests anymore. And I do have some really lovely pieces that I've got this year because I feel like this year I've kind of gotten a little bit more into jewellery. Like throughout my whole life I've just been like happy with one nice necklace, one nice bracelet, one nice pair of earrings, and then I'll just wear the same every day. But I've kind of got a little bit more experimental this year. Well, not really experimental, like I'm still pretty boring. I definitely like a certain type of jewellery, as you'll see, but I've started just to get a little bit more into it and I've built up a really nice, I'd say modest collection. I mean, some people will think this is a lot, for some people this is probably very little, but like I said, I'm quite boring with my jewellery. I like to wear the same things a lot. When I really like something, I'll wear it a lot and a lot. So yeah, that was the longest intro ever. So I don't really know how a jewellery collection video goes because I've never actually watched one, but I guess I'm just going to show you everything that's in my jewellery box. So I really hope you guys enjoy the video. Please don't forget to subscribe if you're new here today, turn on post notifications, and of course follow me on Instagram. So this is my jewellery box. Everything is in here and I absolutely love it. It's from a brand called Stackers, who I think are a pretty popular brand when it comes to jewellery storage, and they do all sorts of like really cool cases and travel stuff, all in this really beautiful like Saffiano leather and like rose gold details. It's really, really beautiful and kind of minimalist but really classy. I love it because it's completely customizable, so all of the layers or the stacks, you can basically choose the layout. So if you have lots of necklaces, then you can get lots of necklace layers, etc, etc. So it's you can basically build the box around your jewelry collection, which I think is really, really cool. And then I've also got this from the same brand, which is my travel jewelry case, which is really, really nice as well. And it's got this adorable little like teeny tiny case, which I take like when I go on like a really small trip, like just to my boyfriend's house, for example, and I just want like a spare pair of earrings or something like that. So yeah, really cute. And it's all like velvety inside as well. It's lovely. So I'm going to show you layer by layer. And I just want to do a quick disclaimer that a lot of my jewelry is gifted, especially a lot of the Pandora stuff, because I've worked with them so much over the last few years. I've got so much gifted jewelry. So I'll show you what I keep in each layer before I go into detail. So this is my top layer and this is kind of like a mix. And it's got like a space for everything. Rings, earrings, bracelets. It's got two long bits at the top for necklaces. Then this is my middle layer, which is a deep layer, and this is where I keep all my watches. And then my bottom layer is for necklaces. So this has pretty much all of my necklaces. It has 5 slots, but obviously you can like double up and put lots of necklaces in there. And it's nice because you can spread them out so they're not gonna get tangled. So I'm gonna start with the jewelry that I'm wearing now. I'm the kind of person, like, I'll have a new necklace and I'll wear it every single day for like months. So these earrings that I have on now are Pandora. I just got these recently because I've kind of only recently this year got into hoops. So I don't like big hoops. These are like as big as I think I would go, and they're adorable. They're little like rose gold diamante hoops, and I just think they look really cute. My necklace is also a recent addition. I think you guys will have seen me wearing it in a lot of my recent videos. I'm actually obsessed. It's from Swarovski. This was a gift from them and it's a little shell, like a little one of those, a cowrie shell, a cowrie shell. So it's a very like in design, as you probably know, and it's actually gold. And I don't usually go for gold jewelry, like ever. I'm either rose gold or silver. So I would never probably have gone for this, but they sent it to me and I'm just obsessed with it. And it has little crystals. It's just really dainty and pretty. And then I also have the matching bracelet, which has 5 of those little shells with the little like pull-up fasten, which I really like because, you know, it's adjustable. I have pretty small wrists, so I always find that bracelets always fall off me. And I just really love how small and dainty this is, but it's really sparkly. Then on this hand, I first of all have this bracelet, which is also from Swarovski. I wear this one a lot and it's their little, it's kind of like one of their staple pieces. So this will never like go into the sale. It's one of their like pieces of their classic collection. I think it's actually their charm bracelet, but I don't have any charms on it. It's just really, really thin and dainty and delicate. It obviously has the crystals in, so it's really sparkly. And then the other bracelet I have on this hand is from Pandora. It's their rose gold pavé tennis bracelet. And again, I just love how delicate and little this is. I'm going to repeat myself so much. in this video, but it's just so pretty and elegant and minimal but sparkly. That's the kind of vibe that I go for, and I think they just look really cute together. Sometimes I even wear it with the gold or a silver one. I feel like when they're so thin and dainty, then you can like pile them up a little bit and it just looks really nice. So now I'll show you all of the jewelry in here. I'll start with a necklace because there's only one necklace in here. I wear it most days actually because it's just kind of special, and it's my Tiffany necklace, my return to Tiffany with the little rose gold key. I love this so much. This was a gift from JJ, my boyfriend, and he also has it engraved at the back, which just says all my love, JJ. But this is my favorite necklace. I wear this every day because it's just like a classic. It goes with everything. I love that it's silver and rose gold, and obviously it's sentimental and special, so I love wearing this most days. And then I have a little matching Tiffany bracelet, which was also a gift. I think this was my birthday present one year from JJ. It was the birthday that we were in LA together, and we bought it from the Tiffany on Rodeo Drive in Beverly Hills, and it was just a really lovely experience. It was so exciting and special, so I really love this bracelet. Again, this is something that I pretty much wear every day. Again, it just kind of goes with everything. It's classic. You can't go wrong, and it's special. This bracelet is a new one, one of my favorites. This was also a gift from JJ this year for our anniversary, which is really lovely. And it's this Tiffany pearl like tennis bracelet. So it's the same as the silver one, except in pearls, which I love because, as you guys know, I'm so into pearls. And I just love how simple this is. It's so elegant and classic. I just love it. Sticking with the pearls for a minute, this is my pearl anklet from St. Kojo, which is one of the businesses that I featured in my black owned fashion brands haul video a few weeks ago. And unfortunately it didn't arrive in time for the video, but I can show you now. I love this so much. It's so adorable. It just looks so nice on your ankle. Like, when I think of anklets, I think of like beads or even like embroidery thread, like the kind of stuff that you get on holiday that's kind of, you know, not that classy or elegant. But this so is. Like, it just looks so pretty. The attention to detail on this is lovely. Like, even the clasp is really pretty, and it just looks super elegant, but like an elegant boho look, which you guys know I love. Then I just have a load of bracelets. So these are like my cuff bracelets. So I keep these all together, and they're mostly from Daniel Wellington, which I think are really nice. I think they're a statement, but still quite minimal. And they just look quite expensive and elegant, and they just really stand out because of the enamel. So I really, really like the white ones, although it does come in blush, which I do like, but I just prefer the white because I feel like it stands out more. So this is the original one, and then they've also got the slim one as well, which I have to say is probably my favorite, just because I always obviously prefer things on the more dainty side. And then there's the original rose gold cuff with no enamel that's really, really thin, and again it just like blends really nicely into the rest of the jewelry. You can kind of stack them, but it still looks dainty. Sorry, I'm gonna say that word so many times, you're gonna hate me. We're gonna have to play the shot game again, guys. When it's fashion, you take a shot when I say Zimmerman. When I do beauty, you take a shot when I say so natural. And when it's jewelry, you're gonna have to take a shot when I say dainty and delicate. I also have this lovely little cuff bangle, which I got as a Christmas present one year. I think it's from Ted Baker, and it's rose gold, and it's super thin and cute. And the ends are like a Cupid's arrow, except the point of the arrow is a heart, which is so adorable. Then I have this bracelet, which is also Ted Baker. I think this must have also been a Christmas present, and this is so pretty, and I don't wear this one enough. It's rose gold again, and it's just got these little like circles in diamonds or fake diamonds, and it's really eye-catching. It's really pretty. I'm actually gonna put this on now so I don't forget. The beauty of like buying all your jewelry in the same kind of style, the same color, is you can like stack them up, you can mix and match them. I feel like at the end of this video, I'm just gonna have bracelets like all up my arm. So next I have quite a few Pandora bracelets. I have a lot of Pandora jewelry all together because, as you guys probably know, I've worked with them so much over the last few years. I first worked with Pandora in 2016, I think, when they took me to Bangkok, which is where their factory is. And it was such an amazing experience to be able to go and see everything in action, like all the jewelry being made. And I just was so enchanted by it. Like, it was amazing. Basically, everything is handmade, and the only reason that they can't say that the jewelry is handmade is because they do use machines, but that's only at certain stages. Like, a lot of the jewelry process is done by hand, and it was just amazing. And they have so many great like initiatives within the company to like really support the people that work for them, like education and enrichment and loads of kinds of things. It was just a really amazing experience. And then in 2017, I did lots of work with them. I did a meetup in London, so some of you guys watching this will remember that because you would have come. And then I did the Christmas video with them, with my sister Coco, to promote the Frozen collection, which was just amazing. So I have these two bracelets from Pandora, and these are kind of part of their more like minimal collection, because obviously Pandora are more known for their charm bracelets, but I just really love their like ordinary jewelry as well. And these are really pretty. They're just like really plain, simple bangles, and they're just really nice for stacking. A bit of a boho feel with the fasten, but obviously very like expensive looking. That's something else I love about Pandora, Swarovski as well. For the most part, like, they are an affordable luxury. Like, they're not cheap, obviously, by any means, but they're not anywhere near as expensive as like Tiffany jewelry, for example, which even the stuff that I have, which is their like cheaper end, is still really, really expensive. Like, I think this pearl bracelet was over £400, which is a lot. Then I also have this really pretty Pandora bracelet. This is their like beaded bracelet with the pavé bead in the middle and the really cute little fasten. So this is really similar to my Tiffany one, and I think they look really pretty together because the Tiffany one has that rose gold heart, which will kind of tie them in, and they're the same style. And yeah, I really, really like this one. I think it looks very expensive. And then I have my Pandora charm bracelets. I have three, and I don't wear them as much anymore. I kind of go through phases, but I do really love them. I love all the charms, and they kind of have like meaning as well. So this is my first one, and I'm sorry for the cringe alert, but this is like mine and JJ's like love bracelet when we first started our relationship 5 years ago. And we got these matching Pandora bracelets. He got the like oxidized, like manly looking one with a silver heart, and then I got this one, which is the silver bracelet with the rose gold clasp with the rose gold heart. So it's all very cute. We don't really wear them anymore, but we both obviously keep them and love them. And then I also got another charm for mine because we just thought it was so lovely, and it's this man and woman like dancing, like old fashioned, you know, ballroom dancing. And I just think it's so beautiful. It's quite old-fashioned, but I just think it's very romantic. So yeah, that's that bracelet. This is the second one I got, and this is the silver bracelet with the little heart clasp. And this was the bracelet that I got for when I did the Pandora Valentine's Day campaign back in 2017. So it's very like pink and girly with lots of hearts. So all my charms are actually pink hearts. I just got like an array of pink hearts for this. And then this bracelet is the one that I put together for mine and Coco's Frozen video. So I really, really love this. If you haven't seen that video, then just type into YouTube Freddie My Love Pandora, or Freddie My Love Christmas Memories Frozen in Time is the title. And it's a really beautiful video of me and Coco like going through all of our Christmas traditions, such as going ice skating, going Christmas shopping in London, going to the ballet. And for every activity that we did or memory that we made, we added a charm to the bracelet. So we have a ballerina, I think on Coco's she has the ice skater. And then at the end of the video, we added the Anna and Elsa charms onto our bracelets. But what we didn't know is that they were magic, and they magically transformed us into Anna and Elsa and took us to a winter wonderland. It's just like a really lovely video, so go and watch it if you have the time. So I really love this. Coco obviously has hers, I have mine. Hers is like more Anna themed, whereas mine is all very like icy and blue for Elsa. And it's probably my favorite brand campaign I've ever done, like definitely the one that I was the most proud of. So I'll show you my earrings very quickly. There's not like a ton, it's just this little section here. So first of all, these, they're from Ted Baker. They have like a pink diamond surrounded by little diamonds and rose gold. They're actually really glam. I just never wear them because I think they're like really big, and I just never really wear like big earrings. I have these ones from Pandora, which I used to wear a lot actually, and I have the matching ring. And these are part of their birthstone collection. Now my birthstone is a sapphire, which is dark blue, which I don't like at all. So these are opals, so October's birthstone, and they're just really pretty. They're like kind of pinky lilac. They're just really, really gorgeous. Then I have these little mini diamante hoops from a brand called Sif Jacobs, who kindly sent me a couple of pairs of earrings, and I've been wearing these like practically every day. They're so tiny, so they're really comfy to sleep in, and they're just really like understated, but they just add like a little bit of cute sparkle to your ears. And these have been like my everyday earrings. I love them. And then Sif Jacobs also sent me these little like square cut diamonds with rose gold, which are just really glam. I haven't actually worn these yet, so they're very shiny and sparkly. Then a couple more Pandora earrings. These ones you will have seen in my video last week. They're little rose gold heart hoops, which are so adorable. Like, I've never seen earrings like this before. I just think they're so cute and adorable, and I'm just really into hoops right now rather than studs, so it's nice to have like a little variation. More Pandora earrings. I have these little rose gold and pink diamante crowns. So I got these when I went to the Pandora's royal wedding event. They threw a big party for the royal wedding a couple of years ago, and this was like in the goodie bag, because obviously it's like a princess tiara, and they're just really pretty. I don't wear them a lot, maybe I should. And then my last pair of Pandora earrings are these, and they're little rose gold mini hoops, but they have the like pave bead in the middle, which again is just like really glam and sparkly, but it's still minimal and understated. Like, it's not really over the top, but they just look really elegant and like subtle glam. Next I have these really cute little pink enamel and rose gold button earrings from Ted Baker. They're just really easy to wear, really simple and plain, but still really girly and pretty. Then also from Ted Baker, I just have their little rose gold heart studs, which I used to wear a lot when I just liked really super plain earrings. I really love Ted Baker jewelry, by the way. I feel like it's so underrated, but it's so beautiful. Everything looks so luxurious and expensive, but it's really not. Like, considering that Ted Baker is a pretty expensive brand, I'd say that it's a premium high street brand, the jewelry, which is stunning, is actually a lot cheaper when you compare it to like the clothes and accessories. So definitely check it out if you haven't already. Next I have these adorable little gold birds with a little like pink diamante. I think these were from Accessorize. I got these years ago because I was in a show when I was like 18, and my character was called Swallow. Any musical lovers out there will know, Whistle Down the Wind. So this was one of my show presents. Next I have a couple of pairs of earrings from a brand called Liars and Lovers, which is a fairly new jewelry brand, and they have a store that's opened on Carnaby Street, and they also sell them online on ASOS. I actually know the owner. Well, I don't know if she's the owner. I probably got that wrong. If she's the actual owner or like the CEO, I don't know. She's pretty important in the company, and she's a family friend. So we went to the store in January for Coco's birthday, where she got her ears pierced, and we picked out like a load of jewelry, mostly for Coco, but I did choose a few things too, including first of all these little rose gold hoops. And these were honestly the earrings that got me into hoop earrings. I did not wear any hoops before January, before these, and I wore them literally every single day until they started to get a little bit rusty, which is probably my fault because I feel like I wore them in the shower a couple of times by accident. But I really love these, and I love Liars and Lovers as a brand because it's so cute and trendy. They have like classic stuff, but also more like statement trendy stuff, and it's super duper affordable as well. But then they also have like a more premium collection as well. I also got these little diamante studs from Liars and Lovers, which are lovely. They're just really sparkly. Coco has them as well, and they look so pretty on her. And then my last few earrings are, first of all, of course, my classic little pearl stud earrings that I would wear most days. I'd say these were probably my most worn earrings ever, because I've worn these consistently for years. I actually got these in Thailand on the Pandora trip. For some weird reason, even though we were there with a jewelry brand, we all went as part of the itinerary to this like Thai jewel emporium. I think it's because jewels like diamonds and other like precious gemstones are cheaper in places like Thailand. So people buy them and bring them home to England and then have them made into a ring, rather than paying like a huge premium for like import and just like general price inflation. But they also had some like ready to wear jewelry, so I picked up these little Thai freshwater pearls, which I absolutely love. They're just so classic. And then a couple of pairs that I got for Christmas this year. These were from my mum and dad, and they're from Anthropologie, and they're teeny tiny little diamante F gifts. And then these ones were from JJ for Christmas. They are teeny little diamonds. These ones are actually real diamonds. So these are actually the only real diamonds I have, I think. I just feel like diamonds at this point in my life, like I feel like when I'm older I'll want real diamonds, but at the moment I just don't feel like it's necessary. I just think that the stuff you can get from Pandora and like the Swarovski crystals are so sparkly and dazzling that sometimes like you can't even really tell the difference. So now I'll show you some of my rings. I don't have a lot, and in fact I've lost rings over the years. Like I had that lovely rose gold Pandora princess ring which I lost. That was actually a present from JJ years ago. And then I had the newer rose gold tiara ring from Pandora which I cannot find either. I know it's in this room somewhere. It's gonna be like in a pocket somewhere. It'll show up one day. So here is my current collection of rings. I don't really have that many. First of all this one, which is a little silver like bead ring, which is from Liars and Lovers. I get so many questions on this ring. This is one of my like everyday rings. Then I have these two rings from Pandora which are like the same but different colors. They're like half enamel, so this one's like cream and pink, this one's gold and silver, and then it has a little like kind of diamante crystal, so this is just plain, and then this one's pink. And they're really cute but I don't really wear them that much. Then also from Pandora I have the little like diamond heart ring which I really like. I think it's very pretty. It kind of looks like an engagement ring. The kind of girl that would have a Disney wedding, I feel like would have this engagement ring. And I'm not being mean because part of me is that girl. Then this one from Pandora is the little October birthstone opal ring that matches the earrings. I used to wear this a lot. Then my last Pandora ring is the little snowflake heart. This one was obviously from my Frozen video. And I think it's pretty. It's very like wintry though. And it just so reminds me of like Frozen and Elsa. Then I have a couple of Daniel Wellington rings. First of all, just the really plain rose gold band. And then the classic ring, which matches the cuff, which has the white enamel, so it's really cute and stands out a lot. And then I have two really random rings. First of all, this one, which is really sad because I feel like it's gotten really tarnished, but I don't even know what this is made of. All I know is that I actually made this ring. Believe it or not, I did actually design and pretty much make this ring. So I basically went to this like workshop, this like ring making workshop. I think they're called the Workbench London. If you type them in, they were so amazing. You can like hire them for events and parties and stuff. And you literally spend hours carving out your design into wax. And it honestly was the most like painstaking experience. It took me so long. And then they take away your wax model and get it actually cast in something metal. So yeah, that is a Freddie original. And then my last ring is one that my mum gave to me. I think it's actually a diamond ring. And she gave it to me because one of her old boyfriends from years ago gave it to her. And I think she just felt like it was a bit weird to wear an ex-boyfriend's ring next to her wedding ring. So she gave it to me and it is really pretty. I just feel like at this point it's a little bit old-fashioned for me to wear like all the time, but I do think it's really beautiful. Like it's very classic and elegant, so it's definitely one that I will keep forever. So thanks, my mum's ex-boyfriend. So that's everything in the top section of my jewelry box. I feel like I'm gonna have to speed up a bit because this is taking so long. I'm gonna show you my necklaces next because there's not too many. So first of all, I have my two shell necklaces from H&M. You guys saw I got these in my Haul Week haul and I've worn them so much. They were so affordable. They were like £9 each or something like that. And I really love them. I got one in all gold. It's the same like cowrie shells as my little necklace. And this one is in like a mix of like actual shell and gold. The only issue is they have gone a little bit like silver, like the gold's rubbed off because obviously it's just cheap jewelry, which is so sad. So if anyone knows how I can rectify that, it would be greatly appreciated. Also from H&M, I've got my little gold padlock necklace, which I think is really cool. Like this is probably my coolest necklace. I feel really like edgy when I wear this, but I feel like it works. Like it works with my style and it just kind of adds a little bit of like, you know, edge to my look. Then I have these two necklaces from Pandora. I have one in the gold, which is pretty expensive, and one in the rose gold. The rose gold I already had from years ago. It's one of my favorite necklaces. And then the gold one, I think they gave me for the Lion King premiere because all of the Lion King jewelry was gold. It was like really rich and opulent. And I love these necklaces especially in the rose gold, because you can wear them two ways. The way that you're supposed to wear it is with the, obviously, like the diamante, which is really sparkly and beautiful, but I also sometimes wear it the wrong way round because you just get like the Pandora writing, and it kind of reminds me a little bit of the Cartier necklaces. I think it looks really very expensive and understated. So if you want to go for more of a glam look, you can go for that side, but if you want to go for a more kind of casual everyday look, then you can wear it the wrong way around too. Then of course I have my lovely pearl and chain necklace. This is from And Other Stories. I just think it's so pretty. It's very standout, but again, it's just like a really classic design. I love the really pale gold. Like, I'm not really a big fan of like yellowy gold, but this is very like champagne-y colored, and I love the way that it sits on the neck, and it just like adds so much to an outfit. Then I have this necklace, which I absolutely love. I think it's so cool. This is also from Liars and Lovers, so this was very affordable, and it's this little gold shell necklace. And this I actually got before I got into like these types of shells. I got this because it reminded me of Ariel. It's got little pearls in the shell as well, and I just think it's so pretty and really cool, and again, it just like adds a lot to an outfit. And believe it or not, that is actually all of my necklaces. So now I'll move on to my deep layer, which has all of my watches and just like a few basically random bits. Obviously, I've been a brand ambassador for Daniel Wellington for about 2 years now. I've been working with them about 2 years, and I really love the brand. I just think it's such an affordable luxury. Everything looks so elegant and expensive, but it's not like bank breaking, which is all that I am about when it comes to style. So this was my first ever like expensive, like grown up watch. I got this when I was 18 with birthday money, when me and my mum went on a trip to New York. I must have got it from Bloomingdale's. It's Marc Jacobs, and I kind of just keep it for sentimental value. I think it's really cute. I just don't love the actual watch anymore, but I loved it at the time, and I just felt like the bee's knees with this watch. Then a couple of years later, when I was 20, I upgraded my Marc Jacobs watch to this Michael Kors watch, which I actually still think is really cute now, but at the time I thought that this was like God's gift to the universe. It's like a rose gold link watch, but the links are like rose quartz, and then it's all like diamante around the face, and it's all like pink and shiny inside with those of diamonds, and it's just really glam. Then very early on into my YouTubing days, I got these two. This one is from Olivia Burton, and I think it's very pretty. I like the three dials in the middle. It kind of gives it a little bit of a vintage look. And then I also got this from Clouse, because I don't know if you guys remember back in the day, like 2016, I did like a couple of videos and Instagram posts for Clouse. So I've got this little baby pink leather one. And then in 2018, I started working with Daniel Wellington. So I have a lot of Daniel Wellington watches. So first of all, these two, I think this is the Melrose watch, and it has that really nice rose gold chain strap, which I really like, and the face is so elegant. So I've got it in the bigger size and the medium, and I definitely had it in the teeny tiny size as well, but it's not here, and now I'm really upset because I don't know where that is. And what's really great about the Daniel Wellington watches is these straps are interchangeable. So you can buy this, and then you can buy like a leather strap and change it, so you don't need to buy two different watches. And then I've also got this one, which I love. It's the teeny tiny size with the white leather strap. And then I've also got this really cute little heart pin that you can put like in the size holes. Then I have this one, which I really like. It's again the really small size, but it has this white canvas strap, which I think looks really kind of like nautical, kind of like, I don't know, Saint-Tropez boat vibes. And then I have my ultimate favorite Daniel Wellington watches. They have the tags in because I got sent these just before the start of lockdown, because they just launched the smaller size in the Iconic link, but you have to get them fitted because they're link watches, so you have to get them adjusted, and it was just before lockdown, so I haven't been able to go and get them adjusted. And then this one just has a tag in because it's a replacement, because one of the screws fell out of my old one. But this is literally my favorite watch, and the reason why I love Daniel Wellington, because when you look at how expensive like the Michael Kors and the Marc Jacobs watches are, you get the same gorgeous luxury effect with these, but they are more affordable, and I just love them. I think they're so elegant. And then last but not least, I have my Michael Kors smartwatch, which I got just before Christmas, and I was so obsessed with it, especially when I went to New York and LA and I was traveling. It's just really good for when you're like on the go and you don't want to get your phone out, and you can just like check your watch and see your notifications. It's just really cool, and it's in like a really glam, like over the top design as well, so I love it. And then I just have my really random jewellery. This is an old little rose quartz Thomas Sabo bracelet with a little bow charm. This is actually from my ex-boyfriend. It's just not really my style anymore, like it's a little bit chunky for me, but at the time, I really liked it. Then I just have a load more bracelets. I have two little thin silver Pandora bangles, which I really like. I just don't wear silver jewellery that much anymore. I'm definitely on rose gold. This is the gold Pandora bangle, which I put in here because I don't really wear gold jewellery. But having said that, I am wearing this gold Swarovski bracelet, so it would actually look really cute together. So I'm going to put this on so I don't forget about it. Oh, this is Pandora. So this is the little Simba bracelet. It is rose gold and it's so cute, but I just don't really like the black braid. But I do keep it because going to the Lion King premiere was just such a big deal for me and Coco. Like, it was so exciting, such an honor. So this is obviously just like a really nice memory of that. Then I have these two bracelets, which I really like. They're just a bit too big. They don't fit in the top section. And this is a bangle from Ted Baker, rose gold with little like kind of crystal embellishment, which is really pretty. And then this bracelet I really love. This is the Kate Spade bangle that me and Josie bought matching when we went to the outlets in Palm Springs. It's just, I kind of think it looks really cool. And then to finish off the video, I have a couple of pieces of like sentimental jewelry, things that I don't wear, but I just keep, you know, for the memories. First of all, this, I mean, to be honest, this isn't actually that sentimental. I have no idea why I have this, but it's a Twisty Pets bracelet. Coco did like a meet and greet with Twisty Pets at Kidzania or Kidtropolis or one of those big like kids conventions, and we just had like hundreds of these Twisty Pets. Then I have this beautiful little silver bangle, which was one of my bridesmaid's gifts when I was a bridesmaid at my cousin's wedding, and I wore this and I just think it's so, so beautiful. I should actually wear this more, it's so classic. Then I have this bracelet, which desperately needs a polish, but it's just been in storage for years. I don't wear it, so that's why it's all rusty. But this is a Lynx bracelet, which is from my ex-boyfriend. So this is like a sentimental one because basically he would get me like another charm for every year of our relationship. Like every anniversary, we would add a new charm onto it. There's actually only three charms. We were together for 4 years. I don't know where the fourth charm is, but yeah, it's just nice to keep stuff like that. I'd never get rid of it. And then this bracelet, which is a very glam diamante cuff. And this was my prom bracelet. Even looking back, it was just magical. And I wore this bracelet, so obviously I will always keep that too. And then finally, the last piece of jewelry I have is this necklace, which sadly is broken and rusty. But this is the oldest piece of jewellery I have, and it just has such nice memories because it was my first like grown-up piece of jewellery. I think I was probably 5 or 6 maybe, and my dad got this for me and I just loved it so much. It's one of those where like they make the metal into your name. There was a shop near us that did it, and they did like all cool stuff like this. So I've got a little Freddy in a heart, and I just thought it was the most wonderful thing in the world, and I'm really sad that it's broken. But again, this is just something that I will keep forever. So guys, that is my entire jewellery collection. I hope you enjoyed the video. Thank you so, so much for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye!